There was in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain priest named Zacharias of the course of Abiathar, and his wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blameless. And they had no child because Elizabeth was barren, and they both were now well stricken in years. And it came to pass that while he executed the priest's office before God in the order of his course, according to the custom of the priest's office, his lot was to burn incense when he went into the temple of the Lord. And the whole multitude of people were praying without at the time of incense. And there appeared unto him an angel of the Lord standing on the right side of the altar of incense. When Zacharias saw him, he was troubled, and fear fell upon him. But the angel of the Lord said unto him, Fear not, Zacharias, for thy prayer is heard, and thy wife Elizabeth shall bear thee a son, and thou shalt call his name John. And thou shalt have joy and gladness, and many shall rejoice at his birth. For he shall be great in the sight of the Lord, and shall drink neither wine nor strong drink, and he shall be filled with the Holy Ghost, even from his mother's womb. And many of the children of Israel shall he turn to their Lord God. And he shall go before him in the spirit and power of Elias, to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the disobedient to the wisdom of the just, to make ready a people prepared for the Lord.
Thank you.
month, the angel Gabriel is sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled in his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. And he shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
Jesus. what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Have you ever noticed that before? You know, there's a teaching out here that says Mary was the, almost like deity. She was sinless, immaculate. She didn't need a savior. Beloved, the offering of two turtle doves and a pigeon, that's a sin offering. This is Mary, chosen by God to give birth to the Lord Christ, who acknowledges before her God that she is a sinner. She offers before the Lord, as it is written, two turtle doves, pigeons. It's a sin offering. After Mary, notice verse 25, and behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And this man was just and devout. He was a godly Jew. He followed the law. He had a love for his God. And he was a committed Jewish man. But notice what the Bible says about him also. Simeon was, quote, waiting for the consolation of Israel. You see that in the text? Israel had a rough relationship with God for many years, up and down, up and down. And God had finally, if you read in the 36th chapter of 2 Chronicles, finally held them accountable for their sin, and their nation had never reclaimed that glory, even in the days of Christ. And so God had made tremendous promises to them, that a seed of David would sit on David's throne, and that he would rule Israel and rule the world with righteousness, and that he would bring in peace and justice. That seed of David would be the consolation of Israel. But even before Israel became a nation, God had promised that the seed of a woman would crush the head of Satan. And not only would he rule and reign physically, but he would what? He would rule and reign the hearts of men. And so Simeon was a just man. The Bible says he was a devout man. But he was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. And verse 26 says this, and it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. So he came by the Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him according to the custom of the law, he took him in his arms and blessed God and said, Lord, now you are letting your servant depart in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen what? Your salvation, which you have prepared before all the face of all peoples, a light to bring revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people, Israel. Here's a just man. Here's a devout man. He keeps the law. He attends the synagogue and the temple regularly. All of the things outlined in the Old Testament that a man was to do, Simeon did. But here he acknowledges he needs a Savior. And God had blessed his heart to be able to see the salvation of Israel wrapped in human flesh. He actually had the opportunity to hold the Messiah in his arms. Beloved, Jesus is the gift. He is not only the consolation of Israel, he is the consolation of every empty heart, of every longing soul, of every wanderer, of every sinner. Beloved, do you know? Do you have a personal relationship with this great God? You know what's amazing about the story as we bring this section to a close? us to imagine a king born in a stable. The eternal God condescended to live as a man. Not just to live as a man, but to suffer persecution, to be blasphemed, to be ridiculed, to be misunderstood. As the scripture says, to come into his own and his own just reject. And then to allow himself to be falsely accused, tried, and nailed to a cross. That's hard to understand. I remember sharing the gospel. We call that the gospel, by the way. The good news that God sent his son, Jesus, to die for sinners like us.
Amen.
I remember sharing the gospel with a friend many years ago. We worked together, and the Lord had put such a burden on my heart to witness to my friend that I prayed and prayed, Lord, we worked together. We worked with Milwaukee Zoo, and we ran a concession there called the Zoo Bill, so we were always busy. And I prayed, Lord, I really would like an opportunity to share Christ with my friend Claire. And the Lord gave it to me. We had a wonderful, wonderful Midwestern rainstorm. I mean, everything just looks like somebody just stuck a hole in the clouds and went bang. So that day we were confined into our booth, we couldn't run our concession, and I had an opportunity to share Christ with my friend that I did. And I'll never forget what she told me. She was a very smart girl. She was a student at Northwestern University. She looked at me and she said, Eric, she said, you tell me that God would die for me is like me saying that I would sacrifice my life for a grasshopper. I wouldn't do that. And I shared with her, I said, Claire, it's even more fantastic than that because there are some things that you have in common with a grasshopper. But when we compare ourselves to the eternal God, we are not. There's no comparison.
Oratory of Messiah. At the end, please stand with them as they're going to be singing a portion from the glorious Hallelujah chorus. At the end of your program, they have the words there. And just follow the choir. Sing any voice you want to sing, do anything, as long as you follow the choir.